Hello, this is Bern, and on today's episode, I'm going to be sharing with you what happens inside a man's heart and mind that make him choose a woman. In other words, how do men choose women? Stick with me. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your greatlifetoby.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, heart-centered, and successful women how you can attract the kind of man you want and create the relationship that you've been craving as a direct result of stepping into the most alive and feminine version of yourself. No need for gimmicks, manipulation, or stupid games. Now, there are different stages that men go through within that allow them to connect with someone, pursue that someone, commit to that someone, and take it all the way. All the way meaning marriage, children, years and years and years and years and decades of living with someone. So I'm going to demystify this process for you, because although it seems chaotic, here's what a guy is experiencing when he takes it all the way. The first stage is where he, in his mind, feels a little jolt of electricity that says, I need to connect, I need to speak with her. I need to connect with her. There's something about her, something about the way she smiles, something about the way she sways her hips when she's walking, something about her radiance, something about there's something special in this woman. I feel something in my heart, in my chest. I need to talk to her. That's stage number one, okay? So once he connects with you, then there is that interaction, how you connect, how you flow, how you express, how you say yes, how you say no, how you radiate, how you open, how you close. All of that moves him to the second stage where he says, man, I spoke with her. I got her number, okay? I want to see her again. I don't want to miss out on the opportunity to understand what's going on here. Is this something solid? Could this grow? Does this have wings to fly or not? So again, that's going to be determined based on when he connects with you. He's either going to feel something stronger that proves his original hypothesis. His hypothesis when he first saw you and said, I need to talk to her, is like there's something special in her. If he connects with you, he doesn't feel it, then your number will be thrown to the trash and you'll never get that call. If he is a courageous man and he felt something strong with you, then his next question is how I want to see her again. How can I see her again? Okay. Third stage is you connect, you go on a date, you go for drinks, you go for dinner, you do something fun. And then he's saying, wow, there's chemistry and there's something beyond just chemistry. It feels like this woman could be someone special in my life. I'm hungry to get to know her. I'm hungry to understand who she is. I'm hungry to understand what makes her tick, what makes her glow, what is she for, what is she against, what does she love, what does she hate? And again, the third stage is reached only when the second stage, right, happened awesomely. Why? Like you had a date and it felt great. You asked good questions. He answered those good questions. He asked you questions and you were able to answer them from a place of knowing. You start to show your value in a strong way when he starts saying that. Now, bear in mind, little asterisk here, this is a conscious guy who wants to connect with you, not a guy who wants to have fun and just play. I'm talking about a guy who knows what he wants and is interested in something long-term. Fourth stage. Okay, he connects with you a few times. He feels something strong. He starts sensing that you have something so valuable to offer, so different from the way he's felt with other women, so special, so unique. So he feels great about himself when he's with you, and he feels great about you based on who you are and how you interact with him. It's a combination of high values that you embody with standards. Your ability to say yes or no, your ability to say let's wait, your ability to say I need more time, all of it, and your ability to shine a surplus of light that makes him feel like $1 trillion walking when he sees you, right? So the fourth stage is I want to make her mine. Like now I have discovered that the thought of some other dude coming around and stealing her from me is not something I'm willing to do. So what must I do to make her mind? That's where the commitment really, really starts. It starts from stage one, but that's where it cements where he knows that he wants to make you his. Fifth stage is a continuation of that one, which is I can't imagine being with anyone else in my life. Yes, she's my girlfriend, but my God, like I just can't imagine life without this woman. I can't imagine that there's anyone in this world that was that's going to be as special, as awesome as this woman is, and I have to take it all the way. That's the fifth stage. That's where he proposes. That's where he asks for your hand in marriage. That's where he has this buys a ring and the whole thing. Now, when that interaction, when it continues growing, when both of you continue putting energy into the relationship, you don't just say, well, now we've made it. It's just all uphill from here. No, once you create that relationship, that's when you have to continue growing, continue expanding, continue learning about relationships, continue being playful, continue creating moments with each other, continue traveling, continue doing the day-to-day stuff that seems so mundane in a way that's meaningful. Understanding that the mundane little shit that happens in life, that's what life is. Those milestones are going to be few and far between every single day, the way you wake up, the way you go to sleep, what you talk about. Those little things are the bulk of what life is about. And if you can do those things in a meaningful, passionate way, in a way that allows you to continue deepening the connection, that's when sixth stage happens, which is where the guy says, I'm willing to sacrifice whatever it takes to grow all together. Why? Because monogamy, lifelong monogamy, is a big sacrifice for both, not just for him, for you as well. Why? It's having sex with only one human being for the rest of your life, is being willing to work things out even when you don't feel like it. It's being willing to understand your partner will change in some fundamental ways, and you have to continue growing and expanding, or you're going to be left behind. It's willing to renegotiate. There's so many reasons why it's a huge sacrifice, but it's a huge sacrifice that's absolutely worth it if you are with someone who has the same mindset, the same vision as you have for life, and who's willing to also sacrifice in her own life. So hope this is helpful to you, meaningful to you in some way. If you do find it helpful, I'm going to ask you to do three things. Number one, click like on this video or thumbs up. Number two, subscribe to my channel. Click the little bell if you want to be notified of new episodes. Number three, most important of all, if you want to take these learnings into a more practical way into your own life, I've created a free video training. Go to the first link under the description of this video, click on that link, enter your name and email, and you'll be immediately redirected to this masterclass that's absolutely free that I created for you. If you are saying, I want more than videos, I want some handholding and help, there's a fourth link, a second link in the description of this video that allows you to apply to work with me. So thank you so much for connecting with me. As always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.